Hi, it's Dwyer. It's Sunday, August 1st, 2021. GamblersAdvisory.com, a free site. BettingAngle.us, a free site. For podcasts, dwyerboxingnews.com. Let's talk about a fight I got wrong. Jack Cullen's victory over Avni Yildirm. But first, remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, gambling involves risks. This fight was a learning experience for me. Let's talk about what surprised me. Now, Cullen is a tall guy. He has a very good jab, but in my opinion, he gives away his height. He leans a bit too much in the pocket. Now, I thought Cullen had a problem going into this fight. I thought he was going to rely on his jab. He's a right-handed fighter. His left jab lines up with one of Avni Yildirim's best punches, which is a looping right hand up top. Yildirim, style-wise, is known as Mr. Robot. He's methodically trying to come inside. He's methodically trying to cut off the ring. When he's at his best, he lets his hands go. He's throwing a lot of punches. I thought that Jack Cullen, I thought incorrectly, that Jack Cullen was going to walk into an Avni Yildirim right hand. That sooner or later, Yildirim's right hand was going to start paying dividends. Because I thought Cullen was going to throw that left jab, have his hand extended, and be open for a counter right looping shot. Right? I also thought that Cullen was going to be too tethered to the pocket, and he was going to end up trading with a guy who hits harder than he does, who is a good body puncher, and who wants to limit you to the pocket. Now, I was wrong. Just be as blunt as possible. What I want people to do, because they're actually special rounds, is look at the first two rounds of this fight. I believe Cullen threads the needle. This fight easily could have gone the other way. I understand. The scoring was unanimous. I understand one judge gave all 10 rounds to Jack Cullen. This fight easily could have gone the other way. What I want folks to do, and I have the highlights in my favorites folder, is to look at the first 2 to 3 rounds. How Cullen is putting on a back foot tutorial. He has a guy coming up on him. Cullen is shooting a jab, and he's doing so on his back foot. And he's playing distance games. He's aware from the opening bell of Yildirim's looping right hand. That's his defensive priority. So you'll notice he's shooting a jab. He's the taller fighter. He's keeping Yildirim too far outside. Then you'll notice that he jumps into the pocket on occasion. There's an element of surprise here. Right? Cullen can't help himself. He jumps into the pocket to trade up close. Even though I don't like his center of gravity, tall guy leaning forward, when if he leaned backward, like Ali, like Vitali Klitschko, right? If he figured out how to lean backward, he'd be able to throw that jab all night. Vladimir Klitschko, another guy who could lean backwards. He could throw that jab all night, and then when Yildirim has to lunge in with the right hand, can just lean and have the punch swing by him. Right? Cullen needs to be in the pocket at least for part of every round. So in the first 3 rounds of this fight, 2 to 3 rounds, Yildirim cannot figure out the distance. He seems to be waiting for the clouds to part, and the sun to come through so that he can land that looping right hand. Right? Understand, Cullen, and I did not see this coming, has Yildirim's right hand completely neutralized in the first 2 to 3 rounds. Right? Cullen starts to fight fast. You notice his jab. Great jab's a beautiful thing. You notice his jab, and you notice he's able to move backwards while throwing it. Right? You understand that Yildirim, who is coming forward, isn't cutting off the ring fast enough. Right? So Cullen, when he's fresh, is magnificent. Yildirim also can't get the timing. In other words, when Cullen throws his jab, you would think Yildirim would have it timed somewhat, given the number of times Cullen's throwing the jab, and would bounce underneath it. You would expect Yildirim to have a bounce. Think Joe Frazier. Think Mike Tyson. The reason the bounce is important is it throws off the other guy's timing, right? You want Cullen to be seeing Yildirim bounce and then to at least momentarily wonder where he should throw the jab. But Yildirim, who is shorter and who's the guy trying to cut off the ring, doesn't have the bounce. So Cullen is able to land the jab repeatedly. In my favorites folder, I have vintage Joe Frazier. It's Joe Frazier against another Hall of Famer. Bob Foster, who people need to understand, pound for pound, is one of the hardest punchers in boxing history. Right? Lightweight champion. Dominant. KO puncher. Well, in that fight, Foster, who has a decent jab, who's taller than Frazier, just like Cullen is taller than Avni Yildirim. Right? Foster's trying to land the jab. Frazier is hunting him down. Just like Yildirim is trying to cut off the ring here against Cullen. The difference, though, is Frazier has that Frazier bounce. Right? So you'll notice Bob Foster really can't stop Frazier, can't time him enough to stand him up outside behind the jab to keep him off of him. Because Frazier's slipping the jab, right? That bounce, Frazier's moving his head, right? Think Tyson when Tyson would go like this. That bounce throws off Foster's timing. Right? So Frazier, of course, is able to get deep in the pocket and is able to throw that looping left hook as well as other punches. Frazier's right hand wasn't that bad. Right? We just don't talk about it a lot because Frazier's left hook was that good. Well, here, Yildirim, let's just say, doesn't have the bounce, and you see what happens when a fighter's too vertical against a taller guy who has a jab and who's comfortable throwing it on his back foot. What I want people to do, too, is to pay attention to, in the film, again, the highlights is in my favorites folder here, is Cullen, and it's masterful. His understanding of where he is in the ring, because the problem with fighting a front foot heavy fighter like Yildirim is you can only back up so much. Sooner or later, you're going to back into the ropes, and you don't want to be pinned against the ropes in dealing with a Yildirim. So you'll notice that Cullen handles it two ways. The first way is he is backing away in a way where his back doesn't hit the ropes. But that's not enough. Yildirim is so front foot heavy that at times, Cullen does have his back up against the ropes. That's when Cullen suddenly jumps in the pocket, right? He can't help himself. He needs to be in the pocket, even though he's tall enough to lean out of it. He'll jump into the pocket suddenly, throw some punches, then when he backs away from the pocket, he does so in a way where he's no longer in the corner. So Yildirim loses the beginning of this fight. Now there's a secret to this fight, and it's interesting. It's one I didn't expect. In around round six or seven, right, after Cullen has already exceeded expectations the first half of the fight, you sense Cullen is winning the fight. Right? You get to round six and seven, then you start to notice that Yildirm can actually land his left hand. Right? Yildirim's right-handed. Cullen is keying on his right hand. He has that looping right up top, right? Overhand right up top. He has that blocked. He has that timed. Yildirm, unfortunately, is too slow in making the adjustment. Now, this is the difference between a Yildirm and, we'll just name a gold standard fighter, a Floyd Mayweather. Right? A Mayweather reads the lay of the land. Right? Mayweather was a slow starter. But by the time you got to round four, Mayweather understood what worked and what didn't work. Here, Yildirm doesn't figure out that he should go to plan B, that he should start throwing left hooks, which are landing, until about six rounds in. So understand, by then, Cullen has a head of steam. Cullen has a lead in the fight. Yildirm lands so many shots that Cullen actually starts bleeding, right? Cullen has a facial injury. But a guy like Cullen, you have to treat like Felix Cash did. You can't allow him to build up confidence. Understand, by the time Yildirm, and this is one man's opinion, it's a losing gambler's opinion on this fight. By the time Yildirm figures out that he needs to rely off his left, that he needs to come in with greater volume and greater lefts, he's behind in the fight. So then we get to rounds 9 and 10, and Cullen is able to close the show. Right? He goes back to throwing a lot of jabs, moving, fighting judiciously, protecting his lead. Right, so I thought this was a casino mispricing. I thought Cullen threaded the needle. Because if you look at the early part of the fight, there are several Yildirm right hands, looping right hands, that barely miss Cullen. And it's interesting because Cullen isn't leaning back and having the punch cross in front of him. Cullen's so high risk that Cullen at times ducks under the looping right hand. Right? So great win by Jack Cullen. If I'm him, I never fight Yildirm again, right? This is the fight where now Yildirm understands if his preferred right hand isn't available, he needs to throw the left hook up top. Right, I think Yildirm also got a little frustrated being unable to land that looping right hand on Cullen, and I believe Yildirm got discouraged because Yildirim's volume is a little bit down, right? He seems to be thinking, you know, gee, he has my right hand blocked, and he seems to be bent on the idea of landing it. Right, so his volume's a little bit down. I would encourage Yildirm to look at films of a guy like Joe Frazier, who, you know, is coming forward. He's not going to be discouraged from throwing punches. Right? You know, a guy who's trying to walk you down, who's cutting off the ring, who wants to be aggressive, needs to be aggressive. Right? That guy can't, if he's being outboxed, you know, then try to, you know, say, okay, well, I need to be more patient while allowing Jack Cullen, who did go into this fight the betting favorite, to jump out to a lead. Right? I was wrong on this fight. I congratulate Jack Cullen on, in my opinion, his best fight, at least the best fight I've seen of his. right? I congratulate him on an excellent jab and an excellent back foot and an excellent use of spacing, right? Kudos to him. I lost on this one. It's a learning experience for me. That's how I see it. Let me hear from you. I'm going to give the Jack Cullen crowd an opportunity to crow here in the comment section of this video. Tell us how you saw the fight. You don't have to agree with anything I've just said. Right? Tell us why you believe Yildirm was unsuccessful, why you believe his volume was a little bit down, why he seemed a little bit tentative to throw punches. Right? And if you feel that a tall guy like a Jack Cullen is giving himself a tactical advantage by actually leaning forward at times, right? Bending over, being forward. Tell us why in the comment section of this video. Thanks for stopping by.